ganas. Oh, mama, tú eres la fama. Estás conmigo y te va mañana. Cuando lo mueves, todo me sana. Eres mi antídoto cuando tengo ganas. Tú me llenes loco.
Café Club Radio. Escucha la mejor música solo por la radio más cargada de la red. Café Club Radio.
Café Club Radio.
Café Club Radio. Escucha la mejor música solo por la radio más cargada de la red. Café Club Radio.
Café Club Radio.
Inicio de espacio publicitario.
Urban Commons. We are a hotel group well renowned in the United States. We operate hotels as it needs to be done. We are currently part of the Luxury Collection for Marriott, also part of the Bonvoy Marriott in the United States. We own the historical well-renowned ship Queen Mary out of California. Come join us at this hotel. It is an adventure.
AirSpace. Hoy en día, el único modo de viajar y ganar. Tecnología innovadora para los viajeros del mundo entero. Descarga el app el 15 de junio. Reserva y gana puntos de criptomoneda. Tu moneda digital global. 150 países, más de 10 millones de hoteles disponibles. Puedes reservar no solo el hotel, sino restaurantes, eventos deportivos, tours, espectáculos, coches, yates, clubes nocturnos y otro tipo de actividades. AirSpace. En Soriano Group nos preocupamos de tus finanzas. Con la capacidad que nos da la experiencia en cuentas de inversión, activos, bonos y fondos mutuos, seguros y anualidades, planes de jubilación, planes de educación, préstamos aquí en los Estados Unidos, cuentas en línea y móvil, seguridad en línea. Visítanos en sorianogroup.com o escríbenos a nuestro mail corporate@sorianogroup.com. Recuerda, Soriano Group, eficaz, sencillo y seguro con tus inversiones.
Recuerda que puedes hacer tu pre-order de la moto eléctrica que cambiará tu estilo de vida. Entra a sorianomotori.eu. Mira nuestro catálogo y toda la información que necesitas. Puedes escoger entre colores, tipos de llantas, tipos de piel para el asiento y muchos más detalles para que escojas los que más te gustan. Y solo en sorianomotori.eu. Ingeniería suprema desde 1920. Y hoy con Soriano Motori conduce hacia el futuro.
Fin de espacio publicitario.
Llegó nuestro momento, siempre en sintonía donde sea que me encuentro. Con Café Club, lo más cool estás oyendo. No me escuchas porque somos como tú. Somos Café Club. Latinoamérica unida en un solo aroma de café. Estamos junto a ti donde sea que tú estés. Sabemos quién eres tú porque todos somos Café Club.
Okay, hello, hello, everybody. How are you today? Thank you for coming. This is Coffee with Soriano, Café with Soriano, para todos nuestros amigos en Latinoamérica y la comunidad hispana en los Estados Unidos. Hoy tenemos a tres mujeres súper increíbles. Alexandra, Joseque Cervera, tenemos a Cristina y tenemos a Monique. ¿Cómo estamos? How are you today?
You didn't mess up your names this time, guys, so be glad. That's actually very, very good.
I reserve the last name for themselves because it's too difficult for me in Spanish or even in English. I don't know. I wanted to hear about from them because it's very beautiful.
Let's start from the top. Let's go, Christina. I got Monique, and right in the middle, I have Alexandra at the bottom. Wait, I'm looking at you guys. Let's start with Christina.
It's hard. My audio is a little low. Can everyone hear okay?
Yeah, we can hear you well.
We hear you just fine.
Yes. So my name is Christina Bartnikowski. I'm a senior advisor for Blue Triangle, and we help with consulting on new business launches, from everything from administration to fundraising, capital raising, anything in the fundraising launch. We can help advise you to get the best deals.
Okay, Christina, wonderful. What about you, Monique?
Thank you.
Hi, everyone. Thank you for having me. What I do, I have a company where right now, thanks to COVID, we're doing a lot of consulting and advisory work. My background's in regenerative medicine. I've had a nursing degree for over 10 years. And I learned how to set up surgery centers and clinics. So I help either doctors, lawyer groups, anybody that, you know, wants to own a surgery center or a clinic. I walk them through either construction, all the policies, the right ceilings, the right floors, all of that. So
if I decide to switch careers to become a doctor, you're the one.
You actually don't have to be a doctor to own a surgery center. And I think that it's going to be something we see more of, because with this whole pandemic and everything, I don't think that people will want to go to a hospital if it's not necessary. And you can really turn any office room into a surgery suite. And so actually anybody can really own
We can all start our own private clinics. That's great. I didn't know that. So you had a nice. How about you, Alexandra?
Hola, mi nombre es Alexandra, soy de Cervera Real Estate. Somos una empresa familiar por 51 años. Estamos ubicados en Miami y hacemos negocios de residencias y comercial.
Genial.
Excellent. Alexandra. We're going to be bilingual today. If you guys don't. Any issues, just hit the SAP button at the very bottom here and it translates automatically for you. I'm joking, Christina.
Like, where's that sound bar?
She's actually looking. You're actually looking for the bot.
You caught me. Like, I don't know. Maybe Zoom has that.
I thought they did too.
Next season.
We're not there yet. We're not.
Marco, but the next season we should have the translation immediately, no, in other language, because on Mondays, 2 times per month. We speak in other language than Spanish and English. So English, Portuguese, maybe French, Catalan, so, and German too, no, Marco? Maybe Russian.
I know. Cool. I don't know about Russian, but we can see. But yeah, part of the show, we'll have some titles. Today's topic is really about family legacy, how to operate a business yourselves, how you position yourself today to kind of build something for the future, following trends, patterns in the market. As you guys know, the next 10 years is what we're calling the peak globalization process. We have basically left behind globalization, right? We're at a different time frame in our lives. We understand that there's a lot of changes in the market, technology, it's gonna be 30 times faster. Data's gonna be crazy out there. So everything that we know about managing our businesses will change for sure in the next 10 years. So the question is, you know, your own strategies, your own advisory, your own positioning, and how you see things and how you're rolling with this whole pandemic, post-pandemic, and different strategies for your own businesses. Right, Tatiana?
Yes. Okay. Yes, it's very important, the family business and the legacy generation per generation is amazing. It's a very talented job. I think most of the time it's very, you know, grateful, but sometimes it's not, maybe not too good. But I wanted to hear you from you, Alexandra, because you are the third generation of Cervera Real Estate.
I'll continue, I guess, in Spanish, since this is Spanish.
More okay. Yeah.
Bueno, como decía Tatiana, soy tercera generación de nuestra empresa familiar. Lo fundó mi abuela y bueno, hay unos hay muchos beneficios de estar en una empresa familiar. Entonces, siempre tenemos el poder de hablar rápidamente, las decisiones se pueden hacer inmediatamente, por si acaso. Por ejemplo, en el caso de esta crisis global con el virus, que podemos enfocarnos en qué es lo que es importante para la comunidad, para nuestra gente y el equipo, y realizarlo en un momento. No somos una empresa que tenemos que reportarnos a otros socios, entonces tenemos la flexibilidad de manejarlo. Pero, obviamente, el mundo no es perfecto. Siendo la tercera generación, típicamente dicen que son los que no van a tener éxito en la empresa. Hay un 13% de porcentaje de poder tener éxito en la empresa. Imagínate la presión que tengo. Entre yo y mi prima estamos intentando hacer todo lo posible. Como decía Soriano, sobre la tecnología, vamos a punto de desarrollar un nuevo producto en agosto que va a apoyar a nuestros agentes, hacer cosas más virtuales, aunque lo de Zoom ya lo empezamos a ver, lo utilizamos ya hace 2 años, porque muchos de nuestros viajes son al extranjero, entonces ya estábamos acostumbrados a hacer este tipo de conferencias antes de.
Sí. Perfecto. So technological adaptation, basically for a third generation going into the fourth, just to summarize what my dear friend Alexandra is doing. And this is because we also have an audience that is listening to us in Spanish. Should you guys choose to speak a native language of your own, feel free to it. We're always cool with that. Monique, tell us more about what does it mean? Why did you start this company? What is legacy to you?
Why did I start this company? Well, because being a nurse for so many years, I've got to see a lot of life and a lot of sadness. And truly, this life is so short. I want to have something, I only want to spend my time doing things that mean something to me. And so I started this company to, you know, set up these surgery centers for people that want to do that or set up clinics and everything. But also being able to help other companies that want to get into regenerative medicine and, you know, stem cell treatments. There's a lot of new therapies there. So to tie in some of like the new tech and rolling with the tech, it's also in medicine too, which is super exciting because if we can heal our body within ourselves and not have to take, you know, drugs or have prosthetic hips or all these things, it's super, super exciting. And I love that. And for legacy for me, I definitely, our big project that we're working on in the background is something that I hope will be around for generations and generations and just be able to help bless people and make them feel good from within and out. So in my family, I have my sister and her husband that work together and I see it beautiful things. So one day this will happen for me too.
Congrats. Yes. I suppose, Christina, maybe since you're on the advisory side of this kind of business, how would you go about approaching a family business and advising them what are best practices?
Well, I come from a different, so Alexandra comes, she is the family office and Monique is creating value in businesses for her future legacy. And from my standpoint, I work for hedge funds and private equity where family office is a form of investment or it's an institutional asset class almost that invests into vehicles, which I'm familiar with. For the most part, family offices have, I don't know if it's best practices, but there's more of conversations about positive succession plans. I think the average age they're saying that someone is having, handed over their family office to the next generation is around 45 years old. I think these conversations are getting a little bit more clearer to clear the legacy of what the one family wants to the other. It's recession proofing your fund and trying to figure out what kind of investments your family will inherit from, generations forward. basically, I come from the institutional side, so it's anything
to very good.
Finances very good. With family office.
Just to kind of further explain to people, in a family office, ourselves, we're a fourth generation. You know, what happens is you have two lineages. You know, you have the patriarchal, the father's side, and you have the patriarchal, which is the mother's side. So whatever the money truly originated, there's a process of connecting. It passes one generation to the next, so that indicates that you get married with the wrong person, that doesn't go away. Typically, that's an issue. But in today's laws, in the U.S., especially when you get married, is whatever you build with your partner from the moment you get married on, that gets split. Anything that was built prior to that remains in the family's assets, but it must be protected. I can give you some background on how those structures play out on the.
I want to ask you, Alexandra, what is the secret, Alexandra, to that your business family is successful? It's very successful here in South Florida. I know you were not only selling properties, you are selling a life, a completely lifestyle. And you care about, you know, the people, the community in Miami. So explain me a little bit about, if you want to do it in Spanish, it's okay.
Por favor.
Bueno, por lo menos la gringa, la que parece más gringa, que habla español, entonces está bien. El nicho para nosotros en nuestra empresa empezó cuando mi abuela trabajaba exclusivamente para los desarrolladores. Y en eso pudo formar como un equipo haciendo las ventas, haciendo los precios y manejándolo uno por uno. Para nosotros, nuestro clave es el nivel de servicio que damos. Tratamos a todas las personas igual como tratáramos nuestra familia, quizás mejor. Entonces, cosas así. Entonces, con ella empezó eso. Mi mamá y mi tía lo crecieron. Y bueno, esperamos que yo y mi prima seguimos. Y hemos representado 120 proyectos en más de 60,000 condominios. Aparte de eso, cosas también exitosas, no solo hablando del cliente, es cómo manejamos al equipo dentro. Como muy típicamente en negocios familiares, es que los empleados están mínimo 10 años, 15 años, 30 años. Somos muy reservados y siempre pensando cómo mantener un buen equipo. Cuando conseguís algo, siempre intentamos algo creativo, cómo mantener a ellos. Y si algo pasa, sabes que somos un poco más flexible, si algo sucede, que es una diferencia que cuando yo trabajé para un banco suizo, tú sabes, era todo 20,000 papeleos para la misma cosa. Yo prefiero que me llamen y resolvemos cosas. Y mucha de la gente de la comunidad, los desarrolladores, nos piden información, cómo crees que ves el mercado. Nosotros somos muy parte de la visión y el crecimiento de Miami. Hemos estado acá 51 años, Miami es bastante joven. Hemos tenido esa suerte comparado con otras ciudades como Nueva York y Los Ángeles, que ya son ciudades bastante antiguas, digamos, en ciertas cosas.
Muy ya desarrollada, tiene razón. ¿Verdad, qué me dice?
Me encanta. Yo quiero saber, what about Cristina? What do you think, if you had like a business family, what is the tools that you will like use, the most useful tools to grow up the business in the vision for marketing or your experience in marketing?
Well, I can't speak to I think that's more for Alexandra and her side because she is the family. So from my side, what I'm more familiar with is for the institutions that help run the family offices. So as Marco explained, there's something called, you know, it's a structure and people work for the family office to help do all their investments. And so I can speak to the operations of those types of firms. I think Alexandra may be best suited to answer for the actual companies. It's, you know, just having an investment team that is, has the same vision alongside with the family wants for multi-generational wealth. right now there's a big, I don't know if I'm answering your question directly, but I know there is a big trend for family offices to do more direct investing, which before you would maybe invest in a fund and then let the fund do the work. And now they want to be more, a little bit more hands-on and entrepreneurial. So that alone can be considered helping build a business within the family office, because you're actually trying to learn, you know, being more active and participating and investing in the asset class. This is also not a direct answer to your question, but I know with the younger generations, they're way more interested in impact investing and socially responsible investing. So that's a theme that's going on with the newer generations within family offices.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
It's not add, necessarily, yes?
And I can add color to
sure.
Families investing in direct deals today based on experience. Also because the technological sector has been adapted forward so many generations. When you're looking at marketing, everybody's thinking social media all the time.
Exactly.
Go back 10, 20 years when we were kids, marketing was, if you knew the newspaper guy, if you knew the radio station, if you knew somebody that can actually help you put the word out there. There were no such things as Facebook, Twitter, or today even. You know, it may to us be a fun thing, but as of today, TikTok is the number one social media company in the world. Monique, now that we're talking about this, are you applying social media at all in any of your strategies to reach out to people that want to start out this sort of businesses? And if you are, how are you doing it?
I did not hear the first part of that question.
Marco, it was a technical issue with your video. If you can, you know, just close the background, because it's going to be like, it's like very slowly, the connection with the video. So it's better YouTube. Yes, it's better.
The volume's a little low on my end. So
exactly. No, it's much better. But
connectivity, people, connectivity. It's just that we pay our bills a little late. So what I was asking is, in terms along the lines of social media, what are the strategies that you're using? How are you implementing social media in your own marketing strategy today?
Well, you know, honestly, it's changed, right? Because this is not we've been working on these other projects in the background for some time that haven't needed any marketing or anything. But for right now, I would say, like, I personally do not have social media and I don't use it. I have a great understanding of it. And I have people that are on my team that when I go and meet with, let's say, a lawyer group or whoever wants to open a surgery center or whatever, that I would be able to advise them to work with these people. And this is how you can, you know, onboard different patients. If it's a med spa, different clientele. And we use that a lot in medicine to get new patients, especially. But the thing is in regenerative medicine as well, there's so many laws and regulations against what you can and can't say. So we work with different FDA liaisons to be able to know what you can say, because you can't say, for instance, like stem cells will cure, you know, whatever. You can't use that. So we use that to help other companies and other individuals that want to own these places. But for myself, it's not like we're trying to keep being bigger and bigger and bigger in that aspect right now. So it's, I hope that answers your question.
So you're not really using social media. See, Tatiana, you don't need to be TikToking every day.
Okay, pero cuando yo hablaba de marketing, ¿sabes? Hablaba, pensaba en eso, ¿no? En esas, sí, cuando le preguntaba a Cristina esas estrategias, a ver si las tools que tuviera sobre marketing ayuda en el negocio familiar. Supongo que estas nuevas generaciones, como tú, Alexandra, pues están más interesados en todo el tema virtual, en interactivo. Por eso Cervera Real Estate viene desde hace mucho tiempo ya entrenando a sus realtors, entrenando a sus equipos de trabajo para que estén en un entorno virtual, y por eso esta pandemia ellos han venido como ya entrenados y han sobrepasado esto mucho más fácilmente que otras empresas, ¿no? Ellos también utilizan, según lo que me comentabas, Alexandra, que utilizas otras herramientas virtuales para que puedan los clientes ver, por ejemplo, cómo va la obra, cómo van sus viviendas, y esto pues ayuda mucho más a la conexión, hacer transacciones desde fuera de los Estados Unidos, en remoto, firmando documentos, y esto ayuda mucho más al negocio. ¿Cómo lo toman las generaciones anteriores a ti? Porque supongo que tú implementaste o has implementado gran parte de este desarrollo.
Sí, yo he ayudado mucho a avanzar las cosas de las tecnologías, aparte con mi prima, en tener una plataforma que se podía utilizar para los documentos y tal. Sí tenemos tres diferentes plataformas para una cosa, pero estamos intentando a ponerlo, antes eran cuatro, ahora estamos en tres y llegamos ya a punto de dos. Puedes firmar todos los documentos, estar en el extranjero, todo very seamless. También tenemos para nuestros asociados, todo el tema del mercadeo electrónicamente, lo pueden utilizar en ese momento. Hablando de lo del tema de social media, yo tampoco no tengo una cuenta, pero como mi empresa lo tiene, es como si yo tuviera, y organizamos todo lo que ellos deben de promover, mucho de Miami, la ventaja de vivir acá, te digo que afortunadamente, lo siento, no extraño vivir en Nueva York ni un momento durante estos momentos. Estoy tan agradecida vivir acá y no necesito social media para ver la playa y ver lo que me hace falta, lo tengo acá al lado, pues.
Por eso más poco vino. Por eso hace más.
Where are you guys? You're in Miami, I'm in New York, Tatiana is in Fort Lauderdale. Where are you, Monique?
I am in Orlando, actually.
All these people.
Everyone's on the sunny side.
And Christina, you're in Philadelphia, right?
I'm in Philadelphia, yes.
Yes. But Christina went out from New York, so Marco is still there. I don't know. He's like running around behind the COVID-19.
20 years in New York. It's been a long run.
Oh, wow.
He is now in Philadelphia. You're still in New York. Last time I saw him.
Yeah, I've moved recently for COVID, which I feel most people from New York have moved recently and are in Miami or what have you.
Yeah, they all brought the disease down here. We're here surviving.
It was me, because I visited Miami, and as soon as I left, everything got crazy. I'm sorry.
Gracias por el regalo, pues. Lo agradezco muchísimo.
He dejado el COVID para toda la gente en Miami, porque tienen el clima bonito.
Yeah, I've been like in home since 4 months ago, since March, the beginning of March, and I'm continuing, and I will be, because my is not going to, the school is not going to open in August, so we'll continue having online classes. I'm sorry, I have to tell you that way because I'm so tired to teach.
You're going to be a teacher all over again.
I wanted to know, you know, I speak something more funny, because I wanted to see, to hear about from you two things. What is the best thing to work with the family, and what is the worst one? Monique.
First, go to the one that doesn't have a family first. No,
where you're a family member got together in the business. So how can you, you know, look at them?
Yeah. Well, I mean, to be honest, like, there's two. So with the consulting and advisory, I would have to, I'll start with the worst thing, would be to help and advise a family-run clinic. It's just really hard to get decisions made and different things. And, you know, it's beautiful. In theory, I would love for it to be a positive experience to work with, but so far those have been the most difficult clients that I've worked with. And for a positive, within my family, my parents included, they've all worked together and they have beautiful, long-lasting marriages. And I think that it's definitely a goal, and that's something I would love to do with my future spouse. And yeah, I mean, there's definitely an ebb and flow and a respect of like this is your lane and my lane kind of thing, I think would be important at that point. But yeah, I definitely think it's positive.
That's very cute. Third's the charm, they say. Watch out.
Hopefully.
Just joking.
Alexandra, Marco, you. What about you?
You, me, the worst?
Yeah, the worst and the good.
Listen, the worst is that I, out of five siblings, I'm the youngest and I am their boss. So it becomes a hierarchy type of issue, right? Because you're the youngest telling the oldest what to do, how to do it, and what not to do. So we have our fights, like we used to have when we were kids, fighting about a toy, only that now we're fighting about a company, right? It happens. And what I've learned, what's the good thing about this, and what you learn is you learn to listen, and then you learn to lead by real knowledge and application. Like if you don't know what you're talking about in my family, you have to be quiet. That's basically a rule of thumb, right? So my brother, I have a lawyer, I have an engineer. So if it's anything legal, I can't really say much. Anything engineer will be my brother, but anything business related, it's all me. Banking, anything, it's me. So we have our roles. We define our roles or functions based on our knowledge and our experience, and that's how we get along. And also we're in different parts of the world, so that distance also helps. ¿Qué dirías, Alejandra, tú, Alexandra, de tu familia? Lo peor y lo mejor.
Lo peor es que siempre estamos hablando de negocio. No hay como intentamos en la hora de la cena no hablar y acabas hablando de negocio siempre. Ah, bueno, me ocurrió esta idea, no sé. O te avisan qué ha pasado en el día. Y ahora que estoy viviendo con mis padres durante este momento para tener más espacio, digamos, de la sala a la habitación, por lo menos en vez de en un apartamento, te notas más que es negocio 24 horas al día. Son unas veces te cansa y quieres decir, oye, mami, ¿podemos hablar de otra cosa que no tiene que ver nada con nada?
Claro.
Eso es lo malo. Pero también lo malo no es tanto entre familia. Cuando yo empecé a trabajar formalmente en la empresa, hubo gente al principio que trabajaba en el equipo que no estaban de acuerdo que yo venía a trabajar. Obviamente me dieron el puesto mi familia, pero yeah, con tiempo y paciencia y siendo amable, siendo la primera a llegar a la oficina, la última en irse, ser respetuosa, yeah, ahí es donde gané. Entonces es la confianza y el respeto de la gente, que eso al principio me costó muchísimo. Yo empecé hace 13 años en la empresa.
Yeah.
Y los beneficios, cosas que he aprendido, porque hace 5 años empezamos este Succession Plan. Somos una familia latina. Me miraron como si estaba hablando chino. Me dijo, ¿qué es eso? Y contraté a alguien. Y fíjate, estaba viviendo en Nueva York. Cada 3 semanas tenía que volar a Miami. No me quejaba tanto. Para 4 días de reuniones con el consultant, hablando de esto. Mi abuela me dijo, ya yo fundí la compañía. El resto es de ustedes. Yo dije, no, yo quería una oportunidad a mantener este negocio. Entonces, en ese momento aprendí mucho la paciencia, igual escuchar, estar súper preparada con todas las notas, porque si te equivocas en una, no te lo perdona en el momento.
Vale, vale, sí, claro.
Entonces, son cosas así con tiempo que tenés que aprender. Y también, yo trabajaba siempre con mi mamá, casi nunca con mi tía. Entonces, eso fue una de las cosas que nos costó al principio a entender la manera que cada uno trabajaba. Yo trabajo de cierta manera y ella de otro. Y ahora estoy trabajando más con mi tía últimamente que con mi mamá y cada uno entre los años hemos aprendido, pero al principio fue cero fácil. Pero si tienes la idea que te quieres quedar en el negocio y quieres que sea exitoso, harás todo lo posible para conseguir, o sea, una armonía entre toda la familia. Y yo sigo, digamos, la tercera generación mandando a todas ellas a organizarse. Fue un dolor de cabeza, pero todos súper agradecidas por el caso.
Te veo bien, con las flores y todo. Estás muy bien. Alexa, something, I want to do a little fun. This is a bilingual one, clearly, with the structure of this one. And this is our last show for the summer, so I really appreciate you guys being here.
What is your favorite phrase in Spanish to the ones that don't speak Spanish? And what's your favorite phrase in English to the ones that do not speak much English? So let's start with you, Monique. What is your favorite Spanish phrase?
Me pick a Spanish phrase?
Yeah. You have to force yourself to say something in Spanish and have fun.
Oh my goodness. I really don't even know. I would pick, nope, I have no idea.
Wait a second, somebody's speaking to you in Spanish.
I'm in the same boat, Monique. I can't answer for French.
They're being safe. They're being safe. It's okay. Don't worry. Nobody's feelings is going to get hurt here. You're okay. This is a safe environment.
When I was young, I went to Tampa to learn English for 1 year, and I had a boyfriend from an American boyfriend. So I speak English like me, like Latin style, Caribbean, you know. And that time, remember, I was like speaking worst, and when he told me something that I didn't understand, I say ferrocarril. Imagine an English a person saying ferrocarril. That was funny.
You used to make him say that so that he stops talking, basically. Ferrocarril.
Never. He can never say that.
I have a funny story. If you want the small one.
Here's an anecdote. Give me some funny stories.
So I don't know if it's that funny retelling it, but I had, let's just say, an ex-boyfriend a long time ago who was Portuguese, and we'd always say, and you can correct me on how you pronounce it, was like, Mira, is it?
Mira.
Yeah, and would say, Mira, Mira, and I thought it was an expression to say like, oh, sweetheart, or something sweet. So for a long time, I thought he was giving me a sweet, like, hey, honey, let's do this. And then I find out it means look.
You thought it was like sweetheart, and like, no, look.
Yes, so for the longest time, I thought it was an expression of love and sweetness, and it was just like, here, you, look.
What do you say?
Oh. True story.
Well, nice. Well, I have to go to commercial break, but after that, I wanted to you to tell me about the big companies now that before were family business, like Ben and Jerry's or Home or Whole Foods or Walmart, maybe Panda Express, you know. And let's talk about that. How can the business family grow up and get to be a global? So we're going to commercial break.
But nice question, girls.
Come back.
They're Googling.
Vamos a corte a comerciales con nuestros técnicos en Latinoamérica, pero ya regresamos con más aquí en Café con Soria.
Café Club Radio. Escucha la mejor música solo por la radio más cargada de la red, Café Club Radio.
Café Club Radio.
Inicio de espacio publicitario.
Remember, you can pre-order the EV Soriano motorcycle today. It will change your life completely. Go to Soriano and see our models to choose from and their relevant information. You can choose colors, rims, tires, and add features to your liking. Go to soriano.eu, engineering since 1920, and today you can ride the future together with Soriano Motorini.
Urban Commons. Son el grupo de hotel mejores reconocidos en los Estados Unidos. Operan los hoteles como debe ser. Son parte del grupo Colección de Lujo por Marriott. Son parte del Bonvoy con el grupo Marriott en los Estados Unidos. Tiene el único barco convertido en hotel, el famoso Queen Mary.
On June 15th, make your reservations and earn crypto points, your digital global currency today. 150 countries with more than 10 million hotels to choose from. You can make reservations for the hotel, restaurants, any sport or music event, transportation, and all else VIP. We have a break now, but we'll be back in a few minutes with more Having Coffee with Soriano at CafeClubRadio.com. At Soriano's Group, we care for your financial security with a long track record of experiences in investment portfolios, stocks, bonds, mutual funds, insurance, annuities, pension retirement funds, education planning, lending all over the United States, all accounts online and on mobile devices, secured portals and access points for your accounts. Visit us now at SorianoGroup.com or write to us directly at corporate@SorianoGroup.com. Remember, at Soriano Group, it's efficiency, simple, and secured with your investment. We will have a break now, but we'll be back in a few minutes with more Having Coffee with Soriano at CafeClubRadio.com.
Fin de espacio publicitario.
Llegó nuestro momento, siempre en sintonía, donde sea que me encuentro. Con Café Club, lo más cool estás oyendo. Nos escucha porque somos como tú. Somos Café Club. Latinoamérica, tenemos un aroma de café. Estamos junto a ti, donde sea que tú estés. Sabemos quién eres tú, porque todos somos Café Club.
Volvemos con esa pregunta, bueno, con esas empresas familiares que se han vuelto grandes compañías, como Whole Foods, como Ben & Jerry's, como Walmart, por ejemplo. Alexandra, ¿cuál es tu visión de futuro para Cervera Real Estate? Como la tercera generación.
Bueno, sería un orgullo ser muy parecido al Walmart. La idea es para nosotros es crear una empresa que podía hacer seguimiento, obviamente, para la segunda, la cuarta, quinta generación. Y la manera que lo pensamos hacer es que cada generación crea algo de valor. Y con cada generación yo soy más para tomar riesgo que las otras. Entonces, ¿qué tipo de negocio nos podemos invertir, que sea un poco diferente, pero algo parecido a la que tenemos? Entonces, eso es la idea de cómo crecer y cómo montar con el inicio del principio de la empresa que hizo mi abuela, ahora cómo llegar.
What about you, Cristina? What do you think this company is growing up to be global, maybe?
What's the bigger question, though? What it would?
Yeah.
How do you take an existing business and you grow it to the point that it's a global company?
Well, I think the key would be to hire competent executives. So what I have seen with certain family offices that I have met, or people that have family legacies, sometimes not all the family members join in growing of the actual business. So there may be one key person who went to, say, business school or what have you. Maybe other of the descendants enjoy the generational wealth, but then one person actually runs the company and maybe it goes down that line. And I think to grow to a global scale, and Alexandra, because you come from this background, you can correct me if I'm wrong, but if I was in this position, it'd be hiring really competent managers that do not have, again, alignment, that have the values of the family, but know how to grow it without interference of the family dynamics, just to really have the business even put first.
What about you, Monique? What are you thinking?
I can see
your eyes.
No, I think that in my realm with healthcare, I definitely agree with you, Cristina, with having, you know, people that work in your company that share the same vision and going the same trajectory, you know, is very, very important. Also, I think to have something like a center or something like that on a global scale, I've been, you know, been able to tour some of these stem cell facilities in other countries and so on and so forth. I think that when it comes to something that's like in healthcare, it would be a trusted name, some kind of a center of excellence, because you're not going to go someplace that, you don't know anything about. You don't know anything about the doctors. They have no credentialing and all these different things. So I think it goes too with a trusted name in healthcare, that it's there's a lot of patient testimonials with that. Those are kind of my thoughts with that.
Interesting. You know, I have a different perspective, because one thing we've learned in 20 years of banking that I've had is that diversification is the only way has been proven that you can minimize any type of risk downturn, right? Most people, most families, they stay within the same trail, within the same mindset. And what happens? The world evolves. And that particular niche market that you used to have stops being the niche market. But if you're not well diversified, whether it's private or public markets, you can lose a lot of your money. In our case, specifically with the legacy assets that were built by my granddad and before, you know, his father, bringing those assets back, but adapting the technology. A good example is the motorcycle business, right? I have no idea about motorcycles. I rode them when I was a child, but if I'm bringing it back, I'm gonna make it an EV. I'm gonna make it an electric vehicle. I'm gonna make it something completely new and luxury style instead of what he built back in the 1930s, which, you know, to some people it was great, but to me, when I look at those bikes, I don't like them. I prefer the bikes that I'm building myself now. But that's part of adapting to new technologies, adapting to new trends, new patterns, and diversifying your portfolio. Like, we do real estate, but we also have this, you know, and you can view it as a fun asset, but it's also like actually really, really.
But Marco, I feel like your family seems to be all, from what you're describing, they all have a business mindset. Some families, not everyone in the family has a business mindset. So I think if you're going to grow maybe Walmart in that direction, sometimes it also takes an outside executive to maybe help smooth out some of the bumps along the way to get to the next 100%. Trajectory.
100%. In our case, every company we've got has got an executive on top that has a lot more experience than I do, that really is passionate about that sort of business. I look at it as a diversification in any of my investments. Except this, the motorcycle is really so far.
Exacto. Yo creo que eso, identificar los roles, es súper importante de diversificar la inversión y estar todos conectados, ¿no? Y buena comunicación para poder seguir y ir sorteando cualquier tipo de problema que pueda surgir y crecer. Entonces, y creo que eso, la leyenda, que las familias sigan creyendo en esa leyenda, ¿no? En ese legado que tienen como familia y como unión para que el negocio siga creciendo y se lo siga entregando a otras generaciones y se entregue a la comunidad, ¿no? A los que te compran, a tus clientes, a los que trabajan contigo. Por eso a mí me encanta, Alexandra, todo el tema de Cervera, porque es un conocimiento que vosotros entregáis tanto a los asociados que tiene como al mismo personal ejecutivo y a la familia. Entonces es bien bonito y es bien importante.
Y para que estemos hablando de gente involucrada en la empresa que no son familiares, es muy importante también entender que la familia tiene que hacer su propia entrevista y merecer estar en la compañía. No te voy a contratar solo porque eres familia. Tenés que trabajar por ello, estar, porque la empresa, tú sabes, cada dólar cuenta y yo no estoy para gastar ni tu tiempo ni el mío. Entonces, y hablando de casados y tal, tenemos una estructura, pues la idea es de que si no eres parte de la familia, esposos no están, tú sabes, involucrado en el negocio, porque no queremos meter eso. Y la idea es en el futuro es crear un board, un advisory board, ya que se vaya creciendo. Y por ejemplo, mi hermana no está en el negocio. Entonces, en algún momento, cuando creamos eso, ella estará en el board, pero no tiene que ver nada con la decisión inmediata. Entonces, cosas así estamos pendientes para las segundas generaciones. Si ves a Mars, a Walmart, todos ellos tienen esa estructura y es la razón que han estado tan sanos y salvos durante todas las crisis.
Verdad.
Okay. Yo quiero ir a mi segmento más personal y quiero mostrar unas fotitos, como siempre. Quiero empezar con Cristina. Cristina, I'm going to show you pictures about you. You make comments about the picture. I love it. I love this one.
That is true. Beautiful. It's not often you get your name on Times Square.
Oh my gosh. It's amazing. Yes. Tell me something about the picture.
Mission continues. I love it. Who do you know at NASDAQ?
I have a good friend at NASDAQ, and they have opportunities for the bell ringing ceremony. So there's a morning bell and an evening bell, and I have helped certain charities, and this one is a veteran-based charity, and I know they had an opening for morning bell, and I knew the head of the charity, so we connected the two, and they get to ring the morning bell. It's very magical.
Yeah, this is
this. I went to a foreign. I did my master's degree abroad. In Grenoble, France, Grenoble École de Management. That's why I can give you a French saying, not a Spanish saying, unfortunately. And anyway, these are my two alumni. I've been the ambassador for everyone who's come through the school through New York to help them get jobs and acclimate, what have you. And the two gentlemen to my left and right are the new ambassadors. That's my legacy. I handed over that torch.
Beautiful. I have some more pictures. I love this one because you're so pretty and you were in an event for the cigars.
This is unique. So Marco, you would appreciate this. There is a competition, it's global. It's called the World Smoking Cigar, Slow Smoking Cigar Competition. In any case, it's how to smoke the cigar the slowest. It's very elegant. And as you can see, this is in a black tie event. And they have events all through the world. And then annually they have a big event in Croatia. And I was the first woman to ever win this competition.
Wow.
Not the final.
Wow, there you go.
Because you're strong. You're a strong girl because you like, you know, you like party, of course, the event, marketing, where you are, you play ball sometimes, and you told me it's very hard to play it because the you know, it's heavy. So you're
a very heavy mallet. Yes.
Yes. You're.
But that's at Warren Buffett's annual meeting.
A sporter.
So I was. Yeah. Oh, this was, I explained, I had a brief meeting before. I was at a Goodwood, which is a race car event in London. Oh, this is at Warren Buffett's annual meeting, which I was very lucky to be there because
This is with the cars, the race cars, no?
Yes, and this is in England. This is outside of London.
Exactly. This is the NASDAQ.
Yes.
I love this one. I have to show this one. Of you on NASDAQ.
Well, that was interesting because our face was on the front of the cover, and then you see our heads looking at the 47th website tower.
I love it. That's very nice. I want to continue with
Monique.
With Alexandra. So, Alexandra, this beautiful picture of you and your family, strong woman.
Three generations, tres generaciones de lengua.
Ahí está, tu abuela, tu tía, tu madre y tu hermana.
No, mi prima.
Prima, vale.
Sí. Las hijas mayores, digamos, de la segunda generación.
Beautiful.
De la tercera generación, digamos.
Cuéntame un poquito de la fundación esta que tiene.
La fundación se llama Orphan Starfish. Tenemos más que 80 programas y lo que hacemos es apoyamos a los niños en escuelas pobres, en orfanatos, en programas de casos abusivos y ponemos centros de computadoras para entrenar a los niños cómo utilizar todo lo de Microsoft Office. Unas tienen coding, otras tienen robotics. También tenemos pagamos el sueldo para los profesores, ponemos el wifi. Entonces, porque una de las cosas de estos niños que viven en la pobreza, vuelven a la pobreza, al prostitution y todo, y no tienen la educación necesaria para poder obtener un trabajo, ir a la universidad. También ofrecemos becas y la organización ha estado para 18 años. Y esta fue en Lima, en Perú, en la ciudad de mi abuela. Entonces lo inauguré de su parte. Y ahí hay 1,500 niños en ese programa.
¡Qué bonito!
Y también lo apoyamos a conseguir trabajo. Entonces es algo para nosotros que va mucho con nuestro negocio, apoyar a los niños, conseguir su manera de salir de la pobreza por su educación, no tanto para darles plata.
Qué bonito, me encanta. Y aquí tenemos una foto más social, más divertida.
Querida abuela, la adoro, es mi gran amor de mi vida allí.
Qué bonito.
Qué bonito, me encanta el tema de la educación porque solamente así podemos, y ahora vengo como Nixi, lo decía que la educación solamente así podemos salir y puede salir Latinoamérica de toda esa pobreza que tiene, ¿no?
Sí, y allí esos niños, uno de ellos va a curar el cáncer, yo no voy a ser, pero quiero ser parte de eso.
Qué bonito. Monique, tell me about this picture, please. This is nice, that too, ¿no?
Thank you. Yeah, this was really, really fun to be a part of an event at NASDAQ. This was a friend's company. They were in the process of going public, and so they had a private event with, it was one of my favorite talks I've seen yet, with some of the biggest names in blockchain and crypto, and then some traditional money backgrounds, like back and forth banter. So that was fun, but I love that photo. The statement's amazing.
I asked her for a picture who, yeah, you know, working, like building the clinic, and she sent me this picture.
To find something so fast, I don't know. I mean, I know I have some with me in it, but that just kind of shows. I mean, just by even looking at that one room, you can see that there are so many different things that go into building that, with all the different medications and all the different policies you have to have each and everything that's in there. It's fun. It's exciting for me.
This is an NBC interview with the blockchain consultant.
Yep. This is when I was living in Switzerland. Actually, this one was taken in LA. And yeah, that was a fun interview because it was after the big boom where everybody, you know, and their dog was in the space. So it was kind of fun when everything died down to really have good conversations with people that were going to last in space. So then I just threw in pictures of my travel. This was in Dubai.
This is your dog, your little dog.
She's my life, Ellie. She's adorable.
I know you love travel.
Thank you. Yeah, that was in Hong Kong. This one was in Malta. This was probably one of my favorite places that I've visited. As well, I just love that island.
Beautiful, I love it. So, right. Marco.
What, you got pictures of me too?
No, I don't have picture of you today. Because I have, I show all your pictures. I have more for the next season. But I wanted to, I have 2 minutes or less. Let's go to the play, you know? I'm gonna ask you a question, girls, and you have to answer me with two words. Only with two words.
Okay, one question, two words, answer, okay? Uno, dos.
Monique, what has been your best moment?
These are hard questions.
Helping others.
Nice.
Christina, what is the worst sales experience you ever had?
Worst sales experience?
Yeah.
let's
I'm not traditionally in sales. I've always more or less run operations, what have you. How about another question?
two words.
I can answer that one if you want.
Okay, great. You answer that one.
São Paulo, Brazil.
What?
Oh, yeah.
What?
I can't imagine why, but
yeah, me too.
Why did you choose, Christina, your cell phone and if not another?
If I have to go somewhere and choose two items?
No. Why did you choose your cell phone and not another one?
Understood. So actually I did both. So I have a Samsung and then I have an Apple iPad. So I have the best of both worlds. I used to have two phones. I had an Apple and a Samsung, and I actually preferred using the Samsung, but I also know you need an Apple product. So I have
two words. Two words.
Instructions.
Like 100 words, but okay. Cool.
I use them both.
That's still not too.
Marco, who will win a battle between Spider-Man and Batman?
Batman.
Why?
Smarter.
It's like the motorcycle, no? Style. Monique, if you could go to lunch with any historical person, who would you choose?
A doctor, I can't pronounce his last name, but he is down in Panama. He's somebody that I've loved to have lunch with.
Can I answer this question?
Hi, Dr. Panama. That was a shout out.
Alexandra, how would you convince someone to wear a seat belt in a vehicle if they refuse to do it?
Don't turn on the car.
Okay, and what about the mask?
That was not two words either. You guys are like missing this whole
the worst.
Game. You're messing it all up. All right, go to Christina. Let's see how many words you're gonna get from her.
Okay, I know who I eat dinner with. I'll tell you that.
Christina, how would you explain to someone how the puncture of a bicycle wheel is fixed?
Next question. Pass.
How would you explain to someone how the puncture of a bicycle wheel is fixed?
Oh, okay. How will you explain to somebody if your bicycle is punctured, how it will be fixed? In two words.
I have to
use a hole in a bike. Come on, you know this.
Patch. Do you use a patch?
Patrick.
Yeah.
Good.
Alexandra, what do you think about the three kings?
About the what?
The three kings. Los tres reyes magos. ¿Qué piensas de ellos?
Very generous.
What? What do you say?
Muy generoso.
Muy bien. Yeah. So, Christina again.
Oh,
but, do you consider yourself a lucky person?
Yes, my birthday's on 7/11.
100 words.
<It's over. laughs>
You're losing. You're losing this.
7/11.
Monique. So you're always open for business.
Hey.
I like that.
The last one for Neat. All of you. Describe in two words, please, what your ideal home would be like if the money were not a problem or inconvenience.
Your ideal.
Con eso pedimos.
Tu ideal qué?
De tu casa. ¿Cuál sería tu casa ideal si el dinero no fuera un problema?
All right. If money wasn't an issue, what is your ideal home? Alexandra, hey, habla tú.
Al lado del mar.
Monique, money's not an issue, ideal home?
Warm family.
You got the dog already, so that's
the stuff. Hey, here you go.
How about you, Christina?
Probably a farmhouse. Animals.
I know this girl is so different. I love
I can give you three. I can give you two dogs and one cat.
Okay.
And you, Marco?
Me, we're Europe. Definitely Europe. I love the US, but I like Europe better. Sorry, guys.
Okay. Sorry, girls. Sorry, Marco, but we have to go.
Sorry.
Yes, I wanted to continue ask you a question, Christina, but we have no time.
Girls, I want to thank you for being part of the last show of this summer. From the bottom of my heart, wishing you guys the best of luck and everything you're doing, and you know where I am if you ever need any help for anything. I'm around.
Tatiana, thank you so much. See you soon. Alexandra, see you soon.
Thank you for being here.
Thank you for having us. Thank you. A toda nuestra audiencia, hasta luego, pero regresamos la próxima temporada pronto después de vacaciones. Así que verano para disfrutarlo y a cuidarse. Be safe, be at home, use mask. Please.
I'll use my shirt.
Bye. Bye.
Inicio de espacio publicitario.
Recuerda que puedes hacer tu pre-order de la moto eléctrica que cambiará tu estilo de vida. Entra a sorianomotori.eu. Mira nuestro catálogo y toda la información que necesitas. Puedes escoger entre colores, tipos de llantas, tipos de pie para el asiento y muchos más detalles para que escojas los que más te gustan. Y solo en sorianomotori.eu. Ingeniería suprema desde 1920. Y hoy con Soriano Motori conduce hacia el futuro.
Grupo de hotel mejores reconocidos en los Estados Unidos. Operan los hoteles como debe ser. Son parte del grupo Colección de Lujo por Marriott. Son parte del Bonvoy con el grupo Marriott en los Estados Unidos. Tiene el único barco convertido en hotel, el famoso Queen Mary.
On June 15th, make your reservations and Ear Crypto Points, your digital global currency today. 150 countries with more than 10 million hotels to choose from. You can make reservations for the hotel, restaurants, any sport or music event, transportation, and all else VIP. We have a break now, but we'll be back in a few minutes with more Having Coffee with Soriano at CafeClubRadio.com. At Soriano's Group, we care for your financial security with a long track record of experiences in investment portfolios, stocks, bonds, mutual funds, insurance, annuities, pension retirement funds, education planning, lending all over the United States, all accounts online and on mobile devices, secured portals and access points for your accounts. Visit us now at sorianogroup.com or write to us directly at corporate@sorianogroup.com. Remember, at Soriano Group, it's efficiency, simple, and secured with your investment. We will have a break now, but we'll be back in a few minutes with more Having Coffee with Soriano at CafeClubRadio.com.
Fin de espacio publicitario.